Right now, we're going to take a look at the Ngetsu lures, which are a slider jig, and it's more than just a jig. Shimano have come up with a whole system that's pretty deadly for catching fish in inshore waters. So first off, here's my little kit. These are the lures themselves here, and there's three components to them. There's the head, and you've got a range of colours and weights. Here they go from sort of 60 through 75 up to 100 gram. And then we've got our skirts, and they come with matching skirts. However, I've found that you can mix and match the colours for the day. And then of course, these deadly little sharp and strong hooks. The three parts go together by chucking them straight onto your leader. Now, the leader I've selected is 20 pound Oshia fluorocarbon. And I go with this Oshia fluorocarbon because it seems to have the thinnest diameter and incredible abrasion resistance. So the Ngetsu lure head goes on first, and there's two holes, a large hole and a small hole. We come through from the small hole, slide that through. Next up is our skirt. Again, slide our 20 pound leader through the skirt. And then lastly, we tie in our hooks. I'm just using a uni knot for that hook. Now that there, skirt slides on top of the hooks and sits inside the head. And there is our deadly little Ngetsu lure ready to fish. But we're not fishing it just on any ordinary gear. We're fishing it on gear that's designed for fishing these. So it's a Shimano Energy Concept rod, which is set up for slow jigging. And you'll notice it's got a lot of guides all the way down low, and that's because of its parabolic action, which just gives the lure just a nice gentle motion. And this reel, it's a bit of a trick. It's the Shimano Ngetsu CT. It's the 100PG. It's just a beautiful little bait caster, but a bait caster with a difference. Got a little wee button on here that I'm going to push, 0.0. It's got a counter on it, so that way we can drop this lure with precision and paired up with my Furuno sounder, where I can see exactly where the snapper are. I can put this thing right in front of their face. So our jig goes in. I've selected just the 60 gram. We're only in 20 meters of water. There's not a lot of drift happening here. And I'm just watching that counter as it goes down. And at the same time, I've got one eye on the screen, and I'm just waiting for some snapper marks to come on, and then I can just simply wind the lure right up in front of them. And in fact, there you go, I can even see my lure dropping on the screen. So now, just as the name suggests, with these slow jigs we fish them quite slowly, so it's basically just a continual slow wind, but every now and then I'm just giving it a little lift, but I'm winding the whole time. Now that lift, what that's doing is that's getting that skirt pulsing, and that seems to be really what gets the snapper going. This reel is just, well, it's custom made for this sort of work. It's a bait caster, so you can hold it all in one hand. The rod's got a wee trigger grip, so it fits beautifully into the hand. And just on the thumb there, you can bop it in free spool, using the counter to drop it right in front of the fish. And then to engage the gear, it's just a wee tap. It really does feel like an extension of your arm. It's beautiful. A nice bit of kit. We've just put up on some more sign, and I can just see my lure, I'm a little bit high, so I'm just letting it down. You can see there that jiggling up and down at the top of the bait. That is my Ngetsu jig wiggling up and down just on top of that shoal of bait fish. Slow, oh there we go, and just dip, 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 dip on the rod tip and wind, and we're tight, yep. And that's how it works. Yes. Those beeps there tell me I'm close, and yes, snapper, net please. And that snapper there, you can see, has just chomped that Ngetsu jig. It actually knocked it first on the drop, one little wind, and boomfa. The Shimano Ngetsu lure and the Ngetsu reel, a deadly combination.